And not
a decade.
All, a decade, and not all of them are happy about the way this is ending, and neither am I. I mean, every time we come on for the 10 and 11 o'clock news, I have to stay off social media so I don't get any spoilers.
Well, I'm not a crazy fan like you are, but I did do a little reading, and I saw that the series had passed the books, and some people were thinking that maybe that's why not everyone's happy.
Yeah, because they don't have something to, the writers don't have something to go off of. But all right, so we've got some showers out there in some parts of our region.
And storms.
Yeah,
if you've been waiting to see a thunderstorm, I think you're going to get one here very soon in the Champlain Valley. We'll take a look. Nothing is severe right now, so that's the good news. Of course, the lightning is still dangerous, so I wouldn't run outside and stand in the lightning. But I think you'll hear some thunder and see it if you look out the window, especially here with this line moving over Lake Ontario and up the St. Lawrence River Valley, the Seaway Valley. Governor will get a storm here soon. And then there's more to this line as you head off to the east. Pretty good one just came through Lake Placid and Saranac Lake, and it looks like it's headed right for Plattsburgh where the Champlain Islands, somewhere in that vicinity. In about 45 minutes should be there, moving about 30 or 40 miles per hour, but it's a pretty consistent line, so really anyone in the Champlain Valley could get a storm. Look at this closer look here in the Burlington area. The rain even starting to pick up with a couple lightning strikes. Again, none of this severe, so we don't have the strong wind or the hail or anything like that, but certainly the lightning and the heavy rain. And it's been raining as well out through central Vermont, certainly out into New Hampshire. The Upper Valley had a storm, but really interesting. We missed out on all the severe warnings today, so it was just the downpours and the lightning. Might be a different story, though, by tomorrow. How about the highs? We had low 80s, 83 in Saranac Lake, 82 in Middlebury, even Rutland and Bennington were at 83. Now, it was cooler to the north. We had clouds, and so that's why the storms so far have been at the south, but that's changing right now. It is cool, though, right now. We have 59 in Plattsburgh, so that's why we're not really expecting severe weather. The air is also a little drier. The stickiness, the humidity, is really down to the south. Middlebury, Rutland, the dew points are in the low to mid 60s, and that means you can feel it a little bit. Not oppressive, but there's humidity in the air. There's the shower that came through Burlington around 5 o'clock. Of course, we have another one right now, but I wanted to show you the nice sunset we had. Certainly a feeling of summer in the air, the feeling that the storms had just gone through. That's what we had around sunset. And the airport right now reporting a thunderstorm, actually, at the Burlington Airport, 59, so it matches what we're seeing on radar. And indeed, there will be some storms lingering for the rest of the night, but I think the next organized round of severe potential is tomorrow, especially south and east of the Champlain Valley in the afternoon. So let's take a look at Futurecast here. Just some lingering storms as we go through tonight. I don't think any of them are severe, but the cold front still has to go through. So once we get things going tomorrow, it warms up, the sun breaks through in a couple spots. I think the chance for a strong or a severe storm, we'll give it another try tomorrow, is PM hours, say afternoon, east of Burlington. So especially if you're in Lebanon or Springfield or point south along 91 into Brattleboro, could be a strong storm tomorrow afternoon. Tuesday doesn't look great. It's cooler. There's a lot of clouds, a shower potentially in the higher terrain, but we're not talking about storms on Tuesday. Speaking of the storms tomorrow, though, the Storm Prediction Center has a level 2 of 5 risk for severe weather, this yellow color here, and clearly it is to the south and east, basically St. Jay through Rutland, south and east of that line, and that's because the front will be going through the region by that point. So for the rest of the night, just a few lingering showers and storms, but not severe. And then tomorrow it is cooler. We're not talking about 80s in Saranac Lake tomorrow, but mid 70s in Plattsburgh, where there could be a rumble of thunder first thing in the morning. We'll call for 80 in Burlington, but the front comes through, and so I think the greater chance, as I said, for storms would be south and east towards Lebanon and down towards Brattleboro, where it's 80. The Marathon, a week from today, looks pretty good. Dry with sun, 60s, 67. For the later finishers a week from today. So here's the forecast going forward. Definitely cooler on Tuesday and Wednesday, but it's mainly dry. Thursday, pretty good, 70, a shower possible. Friday looks decent, low 70s. And the overall look for Memorial Day weekend is good too. Just a few storms possible on Saturday. There may be a shower on Memorial Day itself, but we're not looking at a big rainstorm. So plenty of time for that to change. Tom?